friends, welcome back to another YouTube video. In today's video, we're going to talk about my struggle with finding a job as a data scientist. Yes, it may look like from my profile that I had it easy, but honestly, that shit was hard. Excuse my language, but honestly, that was hard. Like, it was not easy. And I specifically struggled with finding a job as a data scientist in the data science domain. And I'm gonna talk about exactly what are those things that I found are difficult. So before we jump into the video, make sure to give this video a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel if you wanna hear more about data science, tech lifestyle, and everything else in between. So a little bit of backstory in terms of like where I was coming from when I started looking for a job as a data scientist. So at my previous company, I worked there as a data scientist for about 3 years. That's when I decided that I need to leave and I need to like look for my next opportunity and do something different. So I started searching for jobs, like typically how I would go previously before I was a data scientist, I would go and apply for jobs. But pretty much, right? So there are three things that I learned that are pretty much I struggled with quite a bit. Number one are the job titles, such as the title data scientist means different to each company, which means a data scientist at company X does not translate to a data scientist at company Y. And that made my job search much, much harder, because now what I had to do is I actually had to go read the job description, look for like Google open jobs for data scientists, or go to whatever platform that I was using, right? And look for data scientist job. And then I had to like read in between the lines to understand like, okay, is this a data scientist job? Is this an applied scientist job? Is this a data analyst job? So one simple example would be, for example, a data scientist at Facebook does not equal to a data scientist at Amazon or a data scientist at Google. But a person who has not been in the industry or who are new to the industry, they would have no idea. They would apply for the job, and let's say if they get the interview call, they're gonna go into the interview and they're gonna fail because the skills do not match, even though the titles specifically match. So I struggled with that quite a bit, and I had to put in extra work to understand, read all the job descriptions one by one, not pay attention to the title, although I would have to like use the keyword to find the job. So, which is like, it's possible that I probably missed some opportunities because if I was looking for the title and the title does not match, tie up to the job descriptions and does not tie up to my skills, that means like I'm probably gonna like miss some opportunities along the way in that search, in that whole pipeline. So that I specifically found like super, super frustrating, because one thing I wish like that would happen down the road is like, I hope like the data science field gets a bit more standardized compared to other job families, such as software developer jobs or web developer jobs and things like that. The second thing I struggled with was, again, the going back to the job description and aligning, matching the skills is the interview process. Similar to the job titles and descriptions, the interview process was not standardized. The problem does not change, right? I go to the interview, like in the interviews, I struggled with the same thing, where I would be invited to interview for a data scientist role, right? That's what I applied for. But when I go there, the whole interview is pretty much for a data analyst. And that would then give me an idea, okay, like, yeah, that even though like the job description was hiring for a data scientist, a full stack data scientist generalist, but they were actually looking for a data analyst, which again like reminded me that if they are interviewing like this, that every person is hired based on this, that means like the people that I'm going to be surrounded with are primarily are going to be the data analyst or business analyst set of skills. Nothing wrong with that, but it just gives me an idea. So that was also a frustrating part, because I would put in a lot of effort preparing for the interview, coordinating the interview, applying for the job, and then going there, interviewing, sitting there for hours, doing 5 interview loops, just to figure out that this actually is not the role that was listed in the job description, and it's pretty much something else that I am not interested in. So that happened a lot. And that was the most frustrating part, because in the initial search process, I could like look at the job description, I can go back and forth, and I can try to figure out in my own time to like, what does it actually mean? But when I'm already ahead in the pipeline, when I have already put in the work, prepared for the interview, and actually done the loop, sat in a room for 5 long hours talking to 5 different people, going through like those rigorous questions, and just to end up to realize that it's actually not what was portrayed to me initially. So again, like, it all goes back to like standardization that made it pretty difficult. Some interviews end up being very, very like computer sciencey. Some interviews end up being very data analysty or business analysty, which made it like super, super difficult to kind of like end up somewhere. And that increased my, because I would interview and then I would realize like, okay, this is not what I want to do, or this is what's not what is sold to me. And then I'd be like, okay, I don't want to do this. Like, and then I go back to square one and then start doing that thing all over again. So that was the second thing. The interview process again is not standardized. And I hope something happens in the industry where the job descriptions, the job titles, and the interview process eventually gets standardized to some extent. Not like, I know it's never going to be perfect, but to some extent, like, somebody needs to provide some guidelines to all these companies at once, so they're not like each figuring out like labeling their own things next to a job description and doing a very random interview questions and rigor. My last and third struggle with the data science job family was there were not many open roles. Even though like we say like the data scientist is the new thing, it's the sexiest job of 21st century, there were not many data scientist roles. We're looking for jobs in an entire dev team, which is like filled up with like probably 10 people, like would be software developers, PMs, software developer manager, they would need one data scientist, right? So an entire team has only one role open for a data scientist. So let's say if in a company, there are 10 different teams, they're hiring only 10 data scientists, but they're probably hiring 30 software developers to fill those teams. So which makes it very, very difficult, right? Because there are not a lot of openings, and the openings that there are, given that there is so much hype around the job family, there are so many people in the market, right? Which makes it very, very competitive. That means you have to be excellent in your interview performance. And again, like going into the interview, you don't know what you're gonna end up in. So sometimes it's a bit of luck too, right? Like ending up in the right interview loop with asking with the right set of questions that align with your skills and align with your preparation. So yeah, like those are my three things. Like the job titles are not standardized. The interview process is not standardized. And third, there are not enough jobs for the people, the number of people that are in the market. So a lot of supply demand issue, I believe. I know this, I did not give you any tips, but I honestly wanted to. Every video cannot be about tips. I just wanted to share what are some of my common frustrations, which as an individual, I don't think I can solve. I think there needs to be something bigger that needs to happen industry-wide at the industry level for this problem to solve. So, and again, like nothing is perfect. I'm not saying like other job families are perfect, but I think there's definitely room for improvement in the data science job family for sure. So let me know in the comments, what were some of your struggles when you were interviewing for the data scientist role or any family in the under the data science umbrella? I would love to know like what are some of your common frustrations. Did you share any of mine? The three things that I mentioned, any of the things that I shared, did those resonate with you specifically when it came to your job search? Let me know in comments. With that, thank you so much for watching, and I will see you in the next video. Have a beautiful day.